Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. This is Dr. Dabosky. Welcome back for part 3 of chapter 3, which I'm calling chapter 3C. The topic of this short video will be on the closing the books. Let's take a look at what this means from an accounting perspective. So let's talk about the accounting cycle and let's review it from start to finish. So in the first part, we're talking about the measurement process. I kind of want you to think of the acronym Mr. Clean. You know that big bald guy who has the cleaning solution? You ever see those Mr. Clean commercials? Well, Mr. Clean will help you remember the accounting cycle. MR stands for, Mr. stands for the measurement process, where both the external transactions are recorded and posted. Think about the external transactions, the ones we saw earlier in the earlier video on adjusting entries when the cash is actually involved. And then sometimes at the end of the period, we have to post the adjusting entries for the prepayments and the accruals. The next thing is the communication process. So Mr. Clean, think about that as measuring and communicating. And this is where we prepare the financial statements. Now, this is something that you should realize. At first, we prepare our income statement, which is the revenues minus the expenses. The net income then gets closed out into retained earnings, which is the focus of this video. How do we close out the revenues and expenses and dividends, the TRED, the temporary accounts, into retained earnings? And then dividends, as you can see, always get reported and closed out directly into retained earnings. And then finally, we have our ending balance of retained earnings, which appears on our end of the period balance sheet. And then finally, after we're done communicating, we're going to go through the closing process. And this is where we zero out the revenues, expenses, and dividends to retained earnings. So remember the temporary accounts, T, temporary. And then the ones that are temporary are, think of the acronym TRED, T-R-E-D. Temporary is the T, and then the types of temporaries are your revenues, expenses, and dividends. Like the tread of a tire gets reduced to zero over time, so do the temporary accounts get reduced to zero at the end of the accounting period. That might be a nice way for you to remember the temporary accounts. So let's think about temporary versus permanent. If the cash account has a $100 balance, what does that mean? That just means that over the company's life, the cash inflows exceeded the cash outflows by that $100. That means all balance sheet accounts represent activity over the entire life of the company. If the service revenue account has a balance of $100, what does that mean? Well, since it's temporary, it means we zero it out at the end of the period. It means that for this period only, the revenue earned equals 100. And then all income statement and dividend accounts represent activity for the current period only, since they're zeroed out at the end of each period. The temporary accounts, therefore, are closed to get them ready for the next period. Think about it as like restarting the game clock back to zero, so you can keep score of the game for the next game, so you know who won and who lost each game. And again, they're going to start at zero. I briefly touched on this in the prior video. So closing entries, remember from the statement of stockholders' equity, this is how we reconcile from the beginning balance to the ending balance of retained earnings. We start with the beginning retained earnings, we add our net income, we subtract our dividends, and we get our ending balance. So therefore, we need to add net income and subtract dividends, look at the signs and the reconciliation for retained earnings. The balance of an account is changed using journal entries. So this is where we're going to physically write the journal entries so we can update the account balances. It's not a magical process. An accountant doesn't come in and wave a magic wand and say, "A retained earnings update now." No, it's not how it works. It has to be done by a physical journal entry that has to be recorded and put into the accounting systems, the computer systems, so that the account balances get updated. Let's look at the expanded account equation. We've looked at that a few different times. We know that our stockholders' equity can be broken down into two buckets, common stock and retained earnings. This is the internal value, right? The external value to common stock, and the internal value is the retained earnings. We could further break down retained earnings into the beginning balance of retained earnings plus the net income minus the dividends. And we can further break net income down to revenues minus the expenses, which are reported on the income statement. These three things that are circled here, the revenues, the expenses, and dividends, the TRED, remember the acronym TRED, temporary, they get reduced to zero. These are the components of retained earnings. Here's a look at a real life example of the Buckle Company. Let's look at their retained earnings account balance. We could see that it changed from 2014 to 2015. So one fiscal year forward, we know that their account balance went from 238,151 to 224,111. So we can see retained earnings has been updated. Retained earnings actually decreased, as you notice if you take the math, by 14,040. If we go to the income statement, we'll be able to start to reconcile the changes because we know what the components are. We know that they are revenues, expenses, and dividends. That's it. That's all that goes into that account. Well, we know revenues minus and expenses are reported on the income statement, so we know that the company had net income of $162,564. Well, how do we get to the change that we saw earlier of a decrease of $14,040? Well, the only other component we haven't included must be the dividend. So the dividends by default must have been $176,604 for a change in the retained earnings of a negative $14,040, which is exactly what we saw play out on the balance sheet. So our closing entries are pretty simple. What we do to zero out and reset the game clock is that we zero out the revenues by debiting the revenues. Notice that they normally have a credit balance, so by debiting them, we zero them out, and we transfer that balance to retained earnings. Conversely, the expenses have debit balances, so to zero them out, we must credit them and transfer that debit over into retained earnings. And then finally, dividends also have a debit balance, and so we credit the dividends to zero that account out and transfer that debit balance to retained earnings. And if the transfers of the credits exceed the transfers of the debits from the expenses and dividends, that means that you have positive net income. If the expenses and dividends were greater than, or the expenses are greater than the revenues, then you'd have a net loss. It doesn't always have to be profits, everyone, but most of the time we hope the companies are profitable. But this is the way that we zero out the accounts. These are the ways that we zero out the tread. We reduce the tread, like the tread of a tire gets reduced to zero. So do the temporary accounts. Temporary, revenues, expenses, and dividends. Close the revenue accounts. That's how we close the expense accounts. And that's how we close the dividend accounts. The X's mean nothing. In accounting, that's just a skeletal entry when we don't know the physical dollar amount. In the real world, we would know the balance of the revenues we wanted to zero out, and we would use that amount, the real dollar amount. Since this is an example, I just use X's to show you the debits and credits, the increases and decreases of the accounts. Okay? So again, this would be your basic ways of closing: debit revenues, credit retained earnings. That's the way you zero out the revenues. That's the way you zero out the expenses: credit expenses, debit revenues, retained earnings. And you close out the dividends by debiting dividends and crediting retained earnings. This completes our example of how to close out the temporary accounts, the TRED. I hope you enjoyed this video and hope that it was helpful.